Glory, hallelujah, to the Lamb of Jesus Christ, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the one that was and he is to come. To him be all the glory. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. He cries the Lord, for he alone is worthy. For he alone is worthy, for he alone is worthy. He cries the Lord, cause we give him all the glory. We give him all the glory. We give him all the glory. God bless you, sister. God bless you, brother. Oh, Christ has the Lord. We give you all the glory. For you deserve my glory. For you deserve my worship. For you deserve my honor, Lord. We give you all the glory. You are Christ the Lord. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. Your love is more than wine. Your love is more than anything I do. Your love took my heart and gave my soul rest. Your love surpasses my understanding. Lord, your love is so amazing. Amazing grace. How sweet a sound that saves a wretch like me. Oh, amazing grace. How can it be? And that my King should die for me. Jesus, your love has set me free. Jesus, your love has made me whole. Jesus, your love has set my soul free. Glory, hallelujah, praise your name. Glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, I love you more. Glory, hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to the Lamb, glory to the Son, glory to Jesus. We worship you, Lord. I worship you, Lord. I give you my praise. I give you my glory. For you are worthy, worthy to be praised. Lord, you are worthy. You are so worthy, Lord, you are worthy to be praised. Yes, you are. Lord, you are holy. You are so holy. Lord, you are holy to be praised. Lord, you are awesome. You are so awesome. Lord, you are worthy to be praised. You are, Lord, you are worthy, so worthy. You are worthy of my praise. I worship you, Lord. I worship you, Almighty God, 'cause there is none like you. I worship you, Prince of my peace. That is what I want to do. I give you my praise because you alone are my righteousness. Indeed you are. So I worship you, mighty, mighty, mighty God. For there is none, there is none like you. I have no other God like you. Yes, I do. I have no other God but you. You have done what no man can do. Savior, and you will do what no man would do. I have no other God like you. You are wonderful and mighty God. I have no other God but you, Savior. You have done what no man, no one not you. And you will do what no one can do. We lift our voice to you this afternoon and we celebrate your kinship. I celebrate your lordship because you died and rose again. You live eternally. Sometimes when we reflect on our daily dealings with you, it blows our understanding why that you still love us. Who is man that you still love him? The son of man that your eyes is upon. Despite our mistakes and despite our shortcomings, you still love us. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Your love is so great. Your love is so great. A friend, friends will depart because of misunderstanding. But you have never misunderstood man. It pains you, yet you don't misunderstand us. Rather, you share our pains. Thank you, Lord. Jesus' name. I don't know about you, but I can't be God for 5 minutes. Can't be. I don't know about you, but I can't be God for 1 minute. That is why I leave everything in the judgments of God. Sometimes humanity tries to be God. Beloved, even if you think like God for 10 minutes, you have problem. In this sinful world, if you think with God, you are always crying. If Cain is not taken, you open your mouth and curse people because you are God in flesh. Your judgments are not upright, they are not accurate. Therefore, let us come and look through his eyes, love through his heart, and touch through his hands. This afternoon, we want to consider the mystery of Babylon. When the Bible talks about mysteries, they are hidden things that are still not revealed to man. There is one of the mysteries in the Bible that I'm so struggling to understand. The mystery about the resurrection of Jesus Christ and the number of days that he spent on earth. I still don't have an answer. But I hope that one day the Lord is going to give me an answer. It has bothered me for some time that the day that Jesus died and when he rose again from the dead, the Bible tells us that he tarried here on earth for 40 days. 40 days before Jesus ascended to heaven. What was he doing on 40 days? The Bible makes us aware. Absence in the body, presence with the Lord. My account tradition as a Ghanaian, our tradition and culture makes us aware that if a person dies and we have not buried a person, the soul of that person is still around on earth. Now, if a person died for 40 days, the person is still here on earth. There is no scripture based on that. So it's African culture or tradition belief system which hasn't got a proof. It hasn't got basis. And to me, anything that hasn't got a basis from Bible is something which is very wrong. These are some of the belief system that are controlling other people not to be able to be established in divine truth and walk with God. It's a mystery to me that Jesus Christ, when he rose from the dead, he spent 40 days and 40 nights commissioning the disciples, affirming and confirming that he died and he is alive. At a point in time, he appeared before the saints, the disciples in their gathering. And Thomas said, I don't believe unless I see. I believe that Jesus tarried here on earth for 40 days to prove all the critics wrong, that it is me. He wouldn't rush away from the earth. He stayed here for 40 days to prove that he has power over death. I believe. I don't know, but I think that is the answer that I have been searching for all the time. Why would Jesus not go straight to heaven when he resurrected from the death? That is some of the mysteries that we are going to understand at the end of this journey. There is only one question that I believe. Sometimes the Lord will speak to your heart and give you answers. Sometimes you are not sure whether the answers are right or wrong. Today we want to enter into another mystery. In the book of Revelation chapter number 17, the word of God speaks about the mystery of Babylon. And let's see when the Bible talks about mystery of Babylon. What was God trying to teach us? The mystery of the Babylon. The mystery of the woman that sits on the rivers of waters. Yesterday we spoke about that woman. That she is a woman that controls all immoral activities on earth. She is the demon that sits on waters, that control immoral lifestyle, that produces lust in the life of people, both men and women, male and female, young and old, young and old. Yesterday, somebody sent me audio from a young lady who is confessing from Ghana that she and her colleague, about 2,000 young, beautiful, attractive girls, had been sent all over the country Ghana, and their mission is to cause men to cause fornication. Their mission is to win the hearts of young brothers and sisters who are looking after satisfaction, who are searching satisfaction in their heart, secret sin. When Bible talk about secret sin, the highest of them all is fornication and idolatry. Sleeping with a man, sleeping with a woman unknowingly. Idolatry and fornication. That's what I want to GXOS, because that is one of the operation of that spirit. And this audio came right at a time. The young lady said that she was at Polytechnic and that she was introduced into secret society by her mates. And then, because of her beauty, Satan also gave her much beauty that are very eye-catching for men who are looking for seductive women. She said, I am pretty woman from outside. I haven't seen her. But she said, I am quite pretty. I got everything that a man, a lustful man, will see me and desire my service on a word. She said there are 2,000 beautiful young ladies that have been sent into Ghana. And there are 3,000 handsome men. So it's not only the men that are in trouble. We have also men that have been sent to entice young women. Ladies, be careful. Be very careful. The Bible says in Revelation chapter 17, the verses number 1, the word of God says, and there came one of the seven angels which had the seven vials and talked with me. Talk with me. Talking with somebody is different from talking to. Talking with me means we have a dialogue, conversation. Saying unto me, come here, and I will show unto thee the judgments of the great hall that sits upon many waters, the judgment. I'm going to show you the end result of those who allow themselves to be destroyed by fornication spirit. This woman, or this spirit, known as Mami Wata in my country, and maybe your country as well, until West Africa call her Mami Wata. They have different types of names given to that demon. She is a feminine demon in the kingdom of Satan. That woman has been given powers. She had a strong power to entice both men and women to swerve from following God and focus on their lust. She is the spirit behind lust. And I want you to understand, Adam and Eve, they lust after the tree in the garden. The Bible says that when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, Genesis chapter 3, it is desirable to make one wise. It is desirable, that's lust, a desire, a strong passion, a strong desire to seek satisfaction in something that you don't know. It's a false information appearing to be truth. That is lies. That is lies and fear. So Adam and Eve fell out of the lust of the eyes. There was a strong desire. There was a strong desire. This woman, verse 2, with whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth. All the inhabitants of earth had committed fornication. And yesterday we said fornication is sleeping physically, spiritually, emotionally, psychologically with a person who is not legally attached to you, who is not legally your right person to have sexual relationship. Fornication goes beyond sleeping with a woman. But fornication is being captured, being enticed by a feeling that gives you sensual satisfaction. So he carried me away into the spirit, onto the wilderness, and I saw a woman sit upon scarlet colored beast, full of names of blasphemy, having seven head and 10 horns. Full of name of blasphemy, she has seven heads and 10 horns. Go with me to Isaiah The chapter number 23. Isaiah chapter 23. Isaiah chapter 23. The verses number 17. This woman had seven horns. Talk about the authority and the powers and the mediums that she operated through. She operated through media. She operated through culture. She operated through finances. She operated through even churches today. These are the horns. These are the horns, the area where she uses her power to dominate the hearts of men unaware. In our modern time, one of the highest areas is fashion and design. Fashion and design. 23:17. And it shall come to pass after the end of the 70 years that the Lord will visit Tyre, and she shall turn to her high and shall commit fornication with all the kingdoms of the world upon the face of the earth. She shall commit fornication. Fornication simply means a man and a woman becoming one in sexually becoming one with a person whom you are not married to. If you are not married, if you are married, it is called idolatry. Yesterday I spoke about that. Tyre stand for Satan, Sabiata, the devil, the serpent. She is going to fornicate. What does it mean to be fornicating here? How can Satan fornicate? Is he going to sleep with people spiritually? Yes. He is going to satisfy people mental desire and feelings that they can't get from God. A young lady yesterday approached me and asked me, Brother Gabriel, how can a person have an intimate relationship with Jesus Christ? How? You're talking about intimacy. I long for that. I desire. I'm hungry for intimate relationship with Jesus. Brother, show me how. I'm really aware. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 steps. Number one, you must be born again. You must confess your sin that you are a sinner. You must know that if you die in your sin, you are going to hell. You sin because you are a sinner, because fruits comes out of a tree. You have a tree of sin, therefore you don't think to sin. You don't think to lie. You don't think to fornicate. You don't think to gossip. You don't think to disagree with God. Because every sin comes for the Father, you totally disagree with God. When we come into disagreement with God, we sin. Because seed of sin is inherent parts of man, unaware. Man sin unaware, unconsciously. We have conscious sin and unconscious sin. So you must be get rid of the sin nature out of your life before you can have intimacy. Number two, you need the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. Because without him, you can't contact God. And therefore, you must be baptized with water, baptized with the Holy Spirit, baptized with the Word of God, and baptized with the love of God. The Word of God and the love of God. Water baptism, Holy Spirit baptism. The Word baptism, meaning that you need to be a person who loves studying, hearing, listening, reading the Word of God. Studying, listening, hearing, and talking the Word of God. It should be part of your life. You are baptized. Baptizo means to become one with. So, the Word of God must become your basis of information. Is it written in the Bible? The pastors are doing them. I don't care who is doing it. Is it written? The general overseers, you can name them. Hundreds of them that are being adorned on earth. Oh, they worship them. Oh, my general overseer says that. Oh, that is enough. That is enough. Every church that you go, when you go to Deeper Life, the general overseer, when you go to Assemblies of God, the general overseer, when you go to Presbyterian, the moderator, when you go to Church of Pentecost in Ghana, is the chairman. What he says is the final, not what God says. When you go to Catholicism, what Pope says is the final, not what God says. Humanity are being adorned. And these are the people that Satan is using to destroy the plans of God. Curse is a man. Curse is a man that he takes his authority from man without going to God himself. Visit the word of God to have an intimacy relationship with Jesus, intimate relationship with Jesus. You need to be a person who is one with the word of God. Fasting, prayers. Prayer and fasting is the highest roadway map, the highest roadway that you can come into divine intimacy. We don't fast to look slim. We don't fast to look at attractive. But we fast to reduce the desire and the strength of the flesh. Show me a pastor that lack food. And let me tell you, a pastor that condone evil and sin on our world. We fast to reduce the desire of the flesh. The flesh is a burden. The flesh has its desires. It carries man afar off. Isaiah chapter 57 verse 3-7. But draw near hither, ye sons of sorcerers, the seed of adulterers and whore. Against whom do you sport yourselves? Against whom make ye a wide mouth and draw out a tongue? Are you not the children of transgressors, a seed of falsehood? Did you hear that? The prince of Persia, the queen of the coast, the woman that sits on the rivers, she causes kings, men and women, to cause fornication. These are the way that he does. He uses falsehood, fakehood. He uses falsehood to cause men to transgress. He's a liar. And every step that Satan makes is deception. So deception is the highway into all error. Deception is the highway into all error. An abandonment of running away from God. So if you want to have what God has, you need intimacy. And that intimacy comes when you become one with Christ. One in thinking, one in seeing things, one in desire, one in wish. Unless your will become his will, your desire become his desire, your passion become his passion. What you want to die for, become what he died for. What you want to live for, become what he lived for. And that is what intimacy is all about. Talking to this young sister, she said, Pastor, I have a problem. I go off every now and then. I say, well, that is a problem. And that is the definition of who a born-again believer is. So long as you cannot maintain your relationship with Jesus, you are not born again yet. It sounds very, very harsh, but that is the truth. To become born again means you sleep with Jesus every day. You dwell in his presence every minute, every second. There is not a second in your mind that you go out. You don't go out without being confronted by the Holy Spirit. The angels are guarding your mind because you are your mind. Where your mind goes, that is where your personality goes. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is that man. So you are being controlled by your mind. So you don't step out of the coverage area where God's protection cannot be. You don't allow filthy thoughts, stinking, smelling thoughts, feelings and ideas, suggestions and pictures that come into your mind that causes you to stop thinking about God and start thinking about the world, start thinking about satisfaction, which is full of sorrow. This is what the wicked, this is how wicked that demons causes man to operate. Verse 4. Against whom do you sport yourself? Against whom do you violate the counsel of God? Against whom? Against whom make ye wide mouth what you say, and draw out the tongue? Are you not a children of transgressors and seed of falsehood? This is where Satan is fornicating people, causing people to become one with sin, causing people to transgress unknowingly, inflaming yourself with idols. When we talk about fornication, allowing the things of this world to give us satisfaction and the fulfillment that only God can give us. Let me hit it again. Allowing the things of this world, allowing humanity, allowing worldly things to give us satisfaction that only God can give us. That is idolatry. Inflaming yourself with idols. And when we talk about idol, any objects, it can be a cloth, it can be a human being, anything that becomes the source of your happiness, apart from God, is idol. Anything that becomes the source of your beauty, apart from God, is idol. Anything that you relate to that gives you emotional satisfaction, psychological satisfaction, physical satisfaction, which has not been approved by God, is becoming one with sin. And that is why in our morning holiness teaching tells a woman to distance herself from worldly appearances with makeup, eyelashes. Also, men need to also abstain themselves from anything that doesn't look like God, that doesn't conform into the word of God. Any appearances, bodybuilding, sagging your trousers, shaving your beard in a way, making arcs in your face, the Lord is against that. And that you let it grow, let it grow, and maybe cut it a little bit lower, or you take everything out of your face. You remove everything out of it. But cutting here, in the time past, I didn't know. I cut it some half pieces and get a round one and here and there. Oh, it made me look handsome. But that wasn't what the will of God was. Understand these things. Your body is not supposed to be used as a fashion parade that causes man to inflame himself with idolatry. These of idols, things. Under every green tree, slaying the children in the valley, under the cliffs of the rocks. Under every green tree, slaying the children in the valley, Isaiah 57 verse 5b. Among the smooth stones of the stream is a portion. They are the lots. Even to them hast thou poured drink, offering thou hast offered a meat offering. Should I receive comfort in these? Sacrifice, pouring libation, cutting animals, dedicating them to idols, dedicating them to idols. One of our sisters, the Lord showed recently, the Lord took her to Ghana, that Ghana has been dedicated to the devil. With the coming president, known as Nana Akufo-Addo, he has dedicated a country to idol. The day of his inauguration, he invited all demonic forces in the country to come and pour libation. Our country can never come out of this, so long as we don't have men that see things in the eyes of God. So long as we don't have preachers that can become presidents. Country is divided into Islam and Christians. And so long as we don't have one single heart leading the country can never come out of idolatry. As Africans, we believe in African culture, Africa tradition culture. And in our culture are all demonic. Everything is demon. Everything from A to Z. So any person who follows African culture tradition is demonic. God is not in. Any person that follows Islamism is demonic. Nothing of God. Any person that follows Christianity, which is not built on personal relationship, is demonic. We don't have men and women who are living this word. This Bible, we don't have many people who are living it. And therefore, we don't have people that can show it to us. Jesus never included anything in his ministry. So unless we exclude everything out, irrespective of people's view, irrespective of people's comment, unless we are able to live a single-hearted lifestyle that only Jesus we uphold, whenever we bring anything in, is defiled. He doesn't accept. And this is what the Bible says, that through him, the kings of this world have fornicated. The authorities of this world, there is no kinship which is not mingled with diabolical things, secret society. There is nothing like that on earth. Some people will lie to you. Some people will argue about all these things. I don't argue about them because I don't have any interest. If it is not Jesus and Jesus only. Jesus only. No Buddha, no Scientology, nothing. If I become a president, which I can't become one now. I can't become one because I'm no longer a Ghanaian, so I can't become a president in Ghana unless I throw away my German citizenship and I go and fight for. I will first of all cancel any worship in that country apart from Christianity. I will stop Islamism in that country. Nobody can become Islam in that country. So for that reason, I don't think I can become one. Why? Because we are living in the world which is being ruled by the queen of the coast. And his dictates is what goes on. Even your fellow Christian, your so-called Christian council will fight against you. Why do you, we need to live in a peaceful atmosphere. Living in peaceful atmosphere is, to human understanding, is allow sin to grow along with you. That is peace. Allow them to flow. That is peace. Don't condemn it. Don't rebuke it. Don't say God hates fornication. Don't say God hates sin. Don't say homosexuals and lesbianism is evil and it is abominable. And any person that found himself in that environment is going to hellfire and burn. That is not a gospel of peace. If you preach that, it is not peace. Human understanding of peace is allow me to go to hell. Let me have my peace. And which I can't do it. And that is what I'm telling you. Come out of that fake and falsehood that causing men to be bound in this mystery. It's a mystery hidden in the time past. Mystery. That people are not aware of it. Jeremiah chapter number 3. Jeremiah chapter 3. Every man of God that have lived on this earth has been given an eye of the Lord. Every man that God have ever used has been given the eye of the Lord to see what God sees. Condemn what God condemns. Appalled and lift. We are not condemning sin because we feel jealous. We are condemning sin because your soul is going to die and go to hell. And that is what pains me. That is what pains me. And if you preach this gospel, people don't want to hear because it's not a gospel of peace. Peace with who? Peace with sinners. Peace with Satan. We will never have peace with Satan. We can only have peace with God. Jeremiah chapter number 3. Jeremiah chapter 3. Join me as we read a verse number 2. That was, lift up thy eyes unto the high places and see where thou hast not been lined with in the ways hast thou sat for them as the Abram, Arabian in the wilderness, and thou hast polluted the land with thy whoredoms and with thy wickedness. The land that we are living in are polluted. Somebody will ask me, so Brother Gabriel, do we have a Christian country on earth? I'm sorry, there is none. Can we have them? No, we can never have them. We can't. But you will have Christianity in your house. That is the only place that your Christianity can be. Even not in the church. In the church, we don't have Christianity, to be honest with you. The fullness of Christ is not in the church. When you go to every church today, in Easter like this, we have holiness teachers that are condemning Easter. Easter is for a celebration of the queen of what. They argue about all this thing. And then tomorrow they will write Easter convention in their churches. We are having Easter convention in our church. There's a proverb in my language. The river that we don't eat the fish therein, we don't drink the water either. If the fish, we can't eat them, then we shouldn't drink the water. If we are condemning Easter, why do we quote-unquote Easter convention? Something is wrong. Something is wrong. We preach the gospel that we don't believe. We preach. Even holiness preachers, they don't believe the scripture. It's a big problem. No wonder Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, he said, we see in bit and we speak in bit. That is why I'm very, very careful these days. I'm very, very careful these days to stick to only Jesus. Because he is the only one. Only one. Only one. We are promoting evil. We line up with falsehood on our word. We promote them. Lift up your eyes unto the high places and see where thou hast been lying with. Where have you been lying with? Whom are you been agreeing with? Whom are you associating your Christian life with? Something is wrong. Something. Whom are you committing fornication with in this land? Church leaders are endorsing evil, promoting people who are not supposed to be promoted in the churches. We have appointed men and women because they have secular mindset of how to build business. Church is a business today. Church is a business. In a time past, I have a online site. I had a site that I used to put messages of pastors over there. In the beginning, I listened to a man of God, and I love his message. So I contacted him. Said, "Sir, please, I have a site. And I want people to go there and to study the word of God and be informed. So I need some of your material." He said, "You need to buy them. You need to buy them." So at the beginning, I was going to buy them. I sat back and said, "Gabriel, this Bible, I bought it for £150. Or if I'm as a great, 150 euros. That is the only thing I can buy. Should I go and buy a pastor's message? Why? The master that Jesus died for you and me. Should I go and buy it? I won't do that. I will sit down and read my Bible, understand it, and preach to people. Those who want to listen, they can listen. The church is a business. Why should somebody come and buy my message? Why? Pastor, can you tell me why? General Overseer, G.O., can you tell me why? People need to buy your message. Oh, brother, it's because we want to finance the church. No, I don't think so. I am working. I pay my tithes. I'm working. I give my money to the work of God, because the money that I work for, it belongs to God. The money that I labor for belongs to God. My life belongs to Him. My breath belongs to Him. My soul belongs to Him. Everything that comes out of my hand belongs to God. If I come to the level to understand the word of God and the will of God, my money is part of it. Teach me, pastor, to understand the word and the ways of God. And when my life becomes God's, my money becomes His. This is the way we finance the work of God. Teach people to understand the word of God. Let them know that every money that they pay to God, God is using that money for the advantage. A gentleman had a story which is being told in Ghana yesterday. A bishop whom one of his students had a problem. He wanted to buy a land, 70 million Ghana cedis. The guy went and bought the land, and eventually, after paying the money, he saw that the land had been sold to different type of people. So he intended to withdraw his money. In attempt to withdraw his money, he found that it would be very, very difficult for him to get his money back. So he intended to go and seek counsel from his bishop. That bishop has an image in that area. Everybody respect that bishop. So let's go and confound in that bishop. The bishop accepted the fact that, all right, I will help you to collect the money. Lo and behold, he went with them, and the money was given to the bishop. When the bishop received the money, 70 million is not a small money in Ghana currency. Not less than 5,000 to 10,000 pounds, I believe. It's very huge money. The bishop took the money and asked the guy that the Holy Spirit is telling him. The moment the bishop received the money, now Holy Spirit is telling me, you need to sow a seed. You have to use the 70 million to sow a seed to God. That is what the Holy Spirit is telling me. Church is business. In this money, pastors are fornicating with money. They love money more than human soul. They love money more than God. They love money. If you cheat, will you cheat your spiritual son, your so-called spiritual son? I don't believe in son and fathers. I don't believe in that. My father is Jesus Christ. You are preaching that, repent of that foolishness. Let us not call it any person a spiritual father. They will cheat you. They will dupe you. So this guy, according to him, he has been called by God. He's living with a girl that he has given birth with. But this evening, he has not gone to perform the customary rites. That one bishop never knew that this guy has to go and perform the rites before he can even preach. This guy has gone to Bible school, has been ordained as a pastor, but the woman that he is living with, he has not performed the rite. So he said that when the money came, instead of buying the land and started building a house, he said, okay, no. I need to go and perform the customary rites over my wife. The whole thing has become a hot cake in Ghana. I think everywhere they are talking about it today. Because that was broke out yesterday. What a shame. Bishop. You are a disgrace. You are fornicating with money. You don't think about the souls of men. You don't care about where the person got his money from. You don't care. Provided they can sow to God. God who has called me, if he is not able to finance his ministry. God, you have come into your business. Oh, listen to me. I work for company. And any moment I go to where they provide me clothes that I wear. They provide me the outfits. They give me the material, the incentive that I need to perform the job adequately. So when I go to work, I don't bring my gloves. I don't bring my, if I need a bed sheets, if I need a pillowcase, if I need soap for patients, medication, the government provide every. So when you go to the hospital setup or even a care home setup, when you go to that place of your working place, the manager provides all things that you need. Nurses don't bring their strength. Nurses don't bring their medication. They don't bring their pads. They don't bring their whatsoever material that they need to sustain their work. NHS provide every material. If you are NHS staff, God, if you have called me, I don't need to bring my materials. Pastor, can you understand that? If God that you have called, has called you, is not able to finance the ministry that you have been called for, then he hasn't called you. He hasn't called. Don't use dubious means. Don't use fornication and idolatry to win the hearts of me. Deception. Falsehood. The man started cursing this young man because he is trying to get his money back. I will curse you. This is a curse. Quoted all quotation. Acts chapter 5. Ananias and Sapphira died. Achan in the book of Joshua. They will quote all kinds of quotation to let you know that you are rebelling because you don't want to bring your money to their idol worshippers. These men have fornicated. They play hall. Their language is the language of intimidation. Their language is the language of curse. So long as you don't agree with them, the devil is a liar. Jesus never cursed anyone. I don't know why Jesus loves me. I don't know why he cares. I don't know why he sacrificed his life for me. Oh, but I know that he cares. All that I know that he cares. Every minute, every second of my life, he give me breath. When I meet people that need oxygen, oxygen mask is in their mouth. We are pumping 5 liters, 7 liters of oxygen into their brain. Yet they are suffocating. I can't get enough breath. I say, how much do you need, darling? The one outside is not enough. That is what I'm living for. But yours has been, they put pressure on it. That every second, 20, 15, 10 liters of oxygen is being pumping into your system. Yet you can't have breath. He is the control of human life. When you take care of it, you are free. Let us commit our ways unto this God because he's more than able. Let us turn away from fornicators and adulterers. This is the woman that is causing many to sin. Pastors consult them for powers to build their church. And in their power, they lead with intimidation, falsehood, and manipulation. Intimidation, falsehood, and manipulation. They will manipulate you unaware. The moment a bishop will know that end of month, that is the time that they sow seed. Every month they have been sowing seed. Sister, I know that your garden is supposed to be bigger than as it is today. Your harvest is supposed to be bigger because you've sown and sown and sown. But you're not reaping. You're not a good farmer. You're not a good farmer. No. My father was a farmer. We planted cocoa seed, maize, okra, talk about them. Everything. My father planted them. He had animals. He raised animals. Goats, chicken, pigs, and all kinds of things that daddy laid his hands upon. Daddy invested in them. Not single of them that daddy will continue to do if it was not yielding its fruits. I challenge you, if the money that you are sowing into that kingdom, if the money that you are giving into that kingdom, if it is not bringing the output, something is wrong. Something is wrong. If your input is higher than your output, if your investment is higher than your reward, I am afraid you must be fornicating somewhere with the devil unaware. That is a mystery of the hall. She is giving people power today. There are so many scriptures that I can't read. Ladies and gentlemen, he has caused many nations to commit fornication with her. Adulterous religious practices are being practiced all over everywhere. Adulterous. We are serving God, whom we don't see and we don't believe. I preached, I think I had a teachings about blood transfusion and all these things. Somebody said, wow, if my daughter is dying and he said I shouldn't give the blood. Sister, you want to make heaven? You don't want your daughter to make heaven? You're selfish. If we don't die, we don't go to heaven. If a child dies, I'm living every day for the Lord. I don't leave the door open that Satan will strike me at any given point in time. But ladies and gentlemen, I want you to understand that if I die, I die for the Lord. Stop being wise in your own intelligence. Now, if a woman can't have a baby, you can go and do all kinds of surgery. That they would take somebody's egg and put it into somebody and that and that and that and that. Don't be too intelligent to God. Don't be too intelligent than God. Christians shouldn't go through that. If you are living by faith, then take your hands out of anything that you think will produce you quick results. We live by faith. Oh yes, we live by faith. And you have pastors and preachers. We live by faith. But when you talk about faith thing, they will argue with you. But this is not a Bible teachings. What is a Bible teaching, madam? The devil is a liar. You don't believe in what you teach. If my daughter is dying, so Brother Gabriel, if one of your children are dying, are you going to give blood? For where? Blood for where? My blood, is it enough for me? I don't know. I don't know the number of blood. I don't know the quantity of blood in my. So, do I want to die together with her? That is suicide. Hey, son, daughter, if God help you to call you home, you will go alone. I will not follow you. So you don't give your kidney. God gave me two. God is very intelligent to give me two kidneys. If I needed one, he would have given me one. So if one of your daughter's kidney destroys and they need one kidney to survive, survive where? In this life. I know that God rules the affairs of men. You must be engrafted in divine truths. Stop being wise in your own ways. God gave me two, and doctor will say, oh, you don't need two, you need one. You are a liar, doctor. You are not intelligent than God. You want to kill me together with my child. So both of us, we are going to lose one. You see how it is? Better survive. Maybe in my old age, I can give another children. What do I need that children for? What do I need them for? If you are young, you understand you need that to make a family. But that family, if it is not, it doesn't belong to God, I tell you, it's useless. 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 Therefore, the prince of this world is giving us all kinds of things that will cause us to fight against God's will. Fornication does not necessarily mean that sleeping with, but having the ideas that fight against God. Having the thoughts and the knowledge that fight against the mind of God. That is what the prince of this world is doing. She is not a political power. She is not a class as one with the king of the earth. Rather, she causes kings and inhabitants on earth to be drunk with the wine of fornication. What does it mean drinking from the wine of fornication? Taking part of the idea. Taking part of the party. Taking part of the flow. That is the flow of the day. We are doing it. So pastor, don't condemn. Pastor, don't condemn worldliness in the church any longer. They are wearing their big rings and big chains. The bigger it is, that is the bigger your authority in the Lord. The bigger the chain on the neck of the bishop tells you how big he is. And they walk like that. They be eating and eating and eating, and the meat at the back of their head. That is 3 days menu for your entire family. The devil is a liar. And they call themselves bishop. How long are we going to be part of this erroneous religious deception? He, that is the mystery, playing up whore, selling up his ideas and his information, throwing them every minute, every second. Their tactics is working because it's productive to human psychology. Because humanity are not ready to go before God, for God to reveal his mind and his plans to them. The devil is a liar. They will drink from the cup of the wrath. How do we drink from the cup? Accepting what the world accepts. Accepting what the world accepts. Enjoying with them. Condemning them yet partying with them. Condemning them yet associating with them. Condemning. We brought nothing in this world and we will take nothing along with us. Therefore, never allow somebody. You yourself, you don't celebrate birthday, but your friends will celebrate birthday. So every now and then you go and celebrate with them. Me, I don't celebrate my birthday. No. Oh, no. But if you are celebrating, I will come there. Oh, yeah. If you invite me, I will come. You a liar. You a thief. You are promoting evil. What you don't do, you don't promote what others to do. You can't fight against something that you are promoting. You can't endorse something. You can't water what you want to die. How can you water it? How can you water? The mystery of the beast. The mystery of the queen of the coast. The beast which the woman rise according to Revelation. And according to Revelation chapter number 17, verse number 1, verse 3, verse 11 and 15, that beast has given this woman the kingdom that she operates. And she is living in many waters. His territory is river. So we have waters, spirits. If you have lived long in Africa and if you are brought up in Africa, we have a strong belief that in every river there is a demon or a spirit. So drivers, when they are passing through a bridge, they need to give their horn. Papa, 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 papa. Because sometimes the water is sitting in the middle of the road. Sometimes some of the water, they are crippled. And you need to blow the horns. Sometimes they come out, apparently they come out and sit at the bridge. where they are having their party, and if you don't know when you drive pass through, they will cause problem into your life. All kinds of this mystic and demonic. And beloved, if you are not a born again believer, don't venture. It will fight against you. They exist. We are in the spiritual world. These is are the spirits. I had a schoolmate who is one of their fetish priests. As we were going to church, he was jumping on tree and dancing on top of roofs when we were little children. Recently, when I went back home, I said, boy, it's time to come back to Jesus Christ because you're heading towards hellfire. He said, Gabriel, I've been trying to come up, but I can't. I said, you can. Throw all these dirty, filthy things away because they call him Nana, so he's very happy. Nana, Nana, Nana. The devil is a liar. Ladies and gentlemen, the kingdom of Satan has been departed. It has been distributed to some of these demons. So this woman has her own kingdom. And people who are going to marine world will let you know that indeed, that spiritual world is very beautiful. That spiritual world operates with authority and with rules. Things function the way it's supposed to function. When you cause problem, you die straight away. They will discipline you. They will bound you. They will put you into cells. Discipline you. You don't know what people are going through over there. I understand that there is spiritual world. It operates highly against those people whose life has not been given to Jesus Christ. You can be a king. You can be a president. Yet you bow before them. You can be a lawyer. You can be a professor. You can have your PH7AD, whatsoever you call it, but you can be enslaved by such demonic influences and forces. If your heart has not been given to Jesus Christ, you are laboring for this thing. You endorse evil. You don't see anything wrong. You meet them, and when you are talking to them, sometimes I meet elderly people, huge elderly people, and I don't care about their educational background, but I give a due respect to my elders. And when you're talking to them, they speak nonsense. Nonsense, foolishness. Nothing that they say makes sense. Look at them and say, look at you. Me, your little son. I could be your son. I could be your nephew. I could be your junior staff at a workplace. And you talking these things. It doesn't make sense, isn't it? They bow before idol, endorsing, defend anything that is evil. Defend anything that is evil because of lack of knowledge of the word of God in their mind. If a person is not living by the word of God, a tendency that he will endorse anything that is evil and God disapprove is very high. The attire of the great hall identify her as a religious system or as a whole committing spiritual fornication. Duping political powers by her whoredoms and idolatry. The Bible says that she was wearing a purple scarlet, precious stone, pearls, golden vessels in her deceit and wealth of system. She idolizing herself. Idolizing herself, prestige, pride. Pride. Today you see pastors, when you see a pastor robe, other scarlets, you sew it in such a way that they look so gorgeous. Oh my days, oh my dear, oh my dear. Simplicity is what Jesus came for. Now when you see a pastor's gown, pastor's robe, you see that yes, he is a bishop. Lord have mercy. Christ have mercy. Blindness. Lord have mercy on your church. Have mercy, oh God. Have mercy. Mercy. Let mercy say no. This one will never be taken away as a captive. Ezekiel chapter number 23. The verse is number 41. Ezekiel 23 and 41. And sits upon a stated bed and a table prepared before it, whereupon thou hast set my incense and my oil. Whereupon thou hast set my incense and my oil. In a church that is operating through incense and anointing oil, they are committing fornication with the world. And a voice of multitude being at ease was with her, and with the men of the common sort were brought Sabians from the wilderness, which put bracelets upon their hands. Do you have a pastor who is putting bracelet upon your hand? You are causing fornication. Everything is in the Bible, you know. Everything. Where was Jesus burning incense? Where? Now you have false pastors. Hey, Karaya Baba, come and buy this bracelet. It's for free. It's not free. Nothing is free. Spiritual realm. Nothing is free. I don't care what people are doing. I don't care. I don't care. The gospel that Jesus Christ came to preach and live for is the gospel that he expects his wife to preach and live for. I don't depend upon a bracelet. You need this bundle. When you go to Africa, they've now made all these bundles and they are selling it to people. You see people wearing some. I don't want to attack any church here because there are millions of churches. I don't want to attack any church, but I want to attack sin, the spirit behind all these things. You have the kind of verse that they written the name of the church. Jesus' name is not there. If Jesus is not in your hearts, the incense is abominable. The perfume is abominable. The bracelet on your hands is abominable. Abomination. A voice of multitude being at ease was with her. And with the men, they are at ease. They don't see anything wrong. People are patronizing all demonic things in the church today. That is what the great whore does. He has made people to drink from the deception and falsehood that contaminate their spirit, that causes them not to see things in the eyes of God. May God have mercy, may God have mercy, may God have mercy. Verse 43, Ezekiel 23. Then said I unto her that was old in adulterers, would they now commit whoredoms with her and she with them? How long will the church commit idolatry and whoredom, fornicating, whore, prostitution in the church? Spiritual and physical, unaware. Condoning and endorsing evil things. If pastor wear it, there's nothing wrong. Any pastor that put a wedding ring into the hands of a person and said that this is the token of your love, you have broken Genesis chapter number 3. Just Genesis chapter number 2, verse 6, 7, and 8. When God put Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, he didn't put any ring on them. Nowhere in the Bible. Jesus Christ never endorsed that. Never endorsed that. He went to wedding. But when he went to wedding, he messed up their wedding. They had run out of wine. That had made them intoxicated, fornicated. When he came in, he gave them a different wine. That gave them their spirit a relief. They sat back and said, why have you come too late? Why we are so drunk? But at least they were able to make the differences that this one is different from the one that we've been drinking. You might be following false teachings and false pastors, fake ministers. You don't challenge. All that I do is throw challenge on people. Challenge your belief system. I don't speak against the church. I don't speak against denomination. I speak against the spirit behind that denomination. Is it Jesus Christ? It can be Methodist. It can be Assemblies of God. It can be Presbyterian. You can be whatsoever. Deeper Life. Redeem. Now the church has gone many, because every person can form a church now. Every person, quote in quotes. Old and young, everybody is forming a church. Do you know the reason? Because every human being is a church. Every human being is a church. And where two or three people have gathered to praise a church. So churches are many. Human beings are many. We have about 7 billion people on earth. Over 7 billion people on earth. So how many churches? 7 billion churches. Beloved, the Lord is asking you, are you going to join them to hurt him? Are you going to join these people? Yet they went in unto her as they go unto a woman that playeth the harlot. So went they into Ahola and unto Ahiloba, and lewd women. Now, pastors are consultation. When you go back to Africa, they do consultation fee. Before you come to the pastor, you need to pay consultation fee. If Jesus collected the money for people who are following after him, I don't know who will keep that money. I don't know. No wonder the person that kept the money, he was the one that betrayed Jesus Christ with money. Pastors who are following after money betray Christ. Pastors who are preaching the truth, they betray Christ with money. They betray Christ with fame. They betray Christ with position. That when they read that position, their attitude changes. Everything that they do change. Give them a little position. Give them a little position. I was humiliated. I was humiliated as a young boy. I was made Scripture Union president. I think about then even I was a secretary at school, secondary school. And I started using words that are the way I want. And the Holy Spirit said, you can't talk to my wife like that. I said, my God, I'm dead. From that day, I'm very cautious and careful how I deal with people in the church. I'm very cautious because they are the eyebrow of the Lord. And the Lord will see to it that we are the apple of his eyes. So very, 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 very significant and very, very important. The Lord will deal with you, pastors who are tempering and who are misleading the church. The judgment that is going for that woman, I bet you are going to have the same thing. The Bible said that the golden cup was in her hand, full of her uncleanness, spiritual fornication and abomination, by which she dupes political powers, prove her to be a religious power. That is what they do. They portray to have power. Now pastors are trying to get access in political side. And pastor need to be a political leader, a political figure that you can control politics. Christianity and politics, no, they don't go together. Oh yes, they will try and define and bring it together. Love not the world, not the things of this world. Politics is a worldly thing. Jesus said, my kingdom does not come from the earth. I'm afraid any minister that want to mingle himself in politics. You've gone too far, sir. You've gone too far. Country like Nigeria, country like Ghana, Safa, you mentioned it, those countries. That everything is built on religion. We have Muslims, we have this and that and that and that. And you, pastor, you want to stand. Will you be able to get the Christian truth out? Talk less a pastor going under a Muslim leader because of position. The enemy has used all these means to silence the voice of God. This is the mystery of Babylon. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a mystery. The word mystery identifies her with the religious rites and mysteries of ancient Babylon. According to Hyslop, the true Babylonians, which quote 260 sources, the ancient Babylonians spread among all nations. And their objects of worship were the Supreme Father, an incarnate female or queen of heaven, and her son. Very few days, I think Friday is going to be Easter. People are going to celebrate Easter. Well, Jesus never said that we should celebrate Easter. I don't think the early church celebrated Easter either. But it has become the tradition and the culture of the people today. And people celebrate it. In which reason? On what basis? Basis that they want to remember the death of Jesus Christ. As a little boy, Presbyterian boy, on that day, people will put on black. because they are mourning the death of Jesus Christ. People are mourning. People are crying because Jesus is dead. Sister, do you understand the death of Jesus Christ? The day, another day, people are going to be booze. They are going to drink and become intoxicated. You see what the spirit behind all these things. I'm a Kwao boy. My father comes from Kwao. There's a part of Ghana that celebrate this Easter as something so big. And during that time, people go to the mountains area and dedicate their soul to sin, Satan, because according to the spiritual realm, the spiritual ordinances in my country, that part on that mountain, that is their blood bank. So people go there and celebrate. Christians are going there. So I know now in Ghana, they have said, oh, Kwao, Kwao, Kwao. Or the announcement is going on. And thousands go there. They died sometimes. They go and do all kinds of filthy and dirty. You don't understand anything. Don't follow after it. The tradition of men and strangle us unaware. People go and dedicate their soul to the devil. I've learned there is a part that people even travel from Europe here. Those who are in America, they come home and they go to that mountain there. And they go and confess. And they go and dedicate themselves to idols over there. You are living there, but you don't know what it means. Is there a day set aside that a man need to seek God than before? Is there any day? Do you think it's a Sabbath day? No. Every day you need to seek after God. If you stop seeking after God, you start seeking after men. Man-made ordinances and man-made rules that cause people to sink in sin unaware. Causes people to fornicate with the devil. Let's read something from Ezekiel chapter 23, verse 29. Ezekiel 23, 29. 23, 29. And they shall deal with thee hatefully, and shall take away all the labor, and shall leave thee naked and bare. And the nakedness of thy whoredom shall be discovered, both the lewdness and thy whoredoms. I will do these things unto thee, because thou hast gone whoring after heathens, and because thou hast polluted with their idols. When we say idol worship is anything that you celebrate. Anything that you lift up above God in your life. Above God. Some of you are celebrating days. Some of you are celebrating months. I want you to understand the prince of this world, he is not foolish as we think he is. Very intelligent being. He has distributed his demons all over. And people come into contact with this spirit of harlots unaware. The Bible named her the mother of harlots, the mother of harlots, and she is a woman that sits upon waters, and she causes apostasy, causes all kinds of confusion, and bringing all kind of symbol and religious celebration that causes a person to remain here on earth at the coming of the Lord Savior Jesus. All that she does is abominable, abomination. The name of that spirit is abomination. She causes abomination on earth. She uses religion. She uses politics. She uses media. She uses entertainment. She uses culture. She uses currency. She uses literature, history. He uses everything that he has that can fall on it. He can use medicine. Medicine. He's using everything to contaminate the faith. The man will not put his confidence and his faith on God. It will stand babalik. It will prove to be very, very irrational statements. If a pastor will come out and say, if a person is dying, let her die. Let him die. And if he's a Christian, if that person dies, he's going to heaven. It stands very, very, very bad statements. Humanity don't want to die, but we will die one day. The old die, the young die. Rich people die, poor people die. It is inevitable. There are certain things which are inevitable. God, you can't avoid God. you can't avoid God. Death, you can't avoid death. Sickness can be avoided to some extent. Ladies and gentlemen, but death, you can't avoid it. And one final thing that you don't consider is judgments of God. You can't avoid the judgment of God. Therefore, think about it. Every day of your life, every day of your focus, every day on your activity, think about that. That you can't avoid the judgment of God. Do you think about the judgment of God, how the judgment day is going to be? Do you think that God is going to judge you the way you think or the way He has labeled things? Many people will believe in what we want and we don't believe in what we don't want. Now we choose what we believe and what we don't believe. Finally, let's read something from Revelation chapter number 17 as I bring my teachings to an end. I saw a woman, verse 6, the woman drunk with blood of the saints, with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus Christ. And when I saw her, I wondered with a great admiration. That lady, she is full and passionate of destroying souls. That prostitute woman, her focus is people not to make heaven. Her intention is to kill every person. Satan has been doing that from the Garden of Eden. There were only two men, according to the word of God. Only two men that God signifies on earth, recognize on earth for him, Cain and Abel. Cain killed his brother. Why? Because this woman wanted to drink the blood of the saints. She desire in your blood. She desire in your blood. Can she kill a person when she's a born-again believer? No, she can't kill you and you can't drink your blood when you are still saved. So she can only drink your blood after she has been able to convince you to use their materials, to sell your soul to them. Then you are as saints. So hear what the Bible is saying, that he drinks the blood of the saints. Backslider Christians, you will die very quick. You'll kill quick because your blood is hot cake for them. So long as your blood is saved, they can't drink it. But if they can contaminate your blood, pollute it, put something in, because your blood will be tossed for them. If you are still saved, they can't use your blood for anything. But when they get sin, zoom into your bloodstreams, then your blood becomes something that they can feed on. Verse 7, and the angel said unto me, wherefore did thou marvel? I will tell thee the mystery of the woman and of the beast that carry her, which had the seven heads and seven horns. Let me jump verse 8. The beast that thou sawest was and not, and shall ascend out of the bottomless pits and go unto the perdition, and they that dwell on earth shall wonder, whose names were not written in the book of life from the foundation of the world, when they behold the beast that was and it is not and yet is. The beast was not. He became. He went and now come into power. These are people who are going to rejoice because they have taken their name from the Lamb's book of life, even from the day they were born. The day they were born, God bless you, Sister Margaret. The day that they were born, say, may the Lord Jesus fill us with the blood. What kind of blood, Alan? The blood of Jesus? Or the blood that Satan will get and drink? May his blood become our blood, that Satan cannot affect us. People have deleted their name. There are preachers over there, men and women who are preaching against God. They are preaching the name of God against God. They don't believe in what they preach. So their teachings does not actually reform and conform people to Christ. Rather, it pollutes people's understanding concerning the things of God. I throw this challenge onto you. Challenge what you believe. Challenge what you believe and what you stand for. There were people that their name were not found in the Lamb's book of life from the foundation of the earth. While their name were not found there, They took their name off. They were born into it. They have been born into it. I believe God is just. I believe God is just. I can't tell, but I can't prove it, but I know that humanity, by one way or the other, choose the mother they want to go in, the family they want to join them. People choose the parent they want to be there. Life is a choice. Everything is built on choice. God will not bring people here on earth and say, you go to Islam, knowing that those people are not going to be saved and come back to him. God will never choose for them. I believe it's a mystery that we don't understand. If we pre-existed, according to Jeremiah, the Lord said, before you came into your mother's womb, I knew you. I knew you before you, your mother conceived you. I knew you. That is what he's saying here. Our pre-existence life has proved us right or wrong. I know, and I believe that men choose where they want to be. Parents, they want to go through them. Family, they want to be part with. Choices are there. And the same choice is still on you now. The church that you want to go. The belief system you want to grow up with. And where your soul wants to be. Challenge your church. Challenge your teachings. Challenge it on your knees. Challenge it in your mouth. Because God is always there to listen to us and to show us the way of truth. As you are studying the word of God with me, it is my prayer that you allow the mysteries in the Bible. There are so many mysteries in the Bible. Today I'm dealing with mysteries. Mystery number one that I spoke about, why would Jesus not go to heaven straight away after his resurrection? 40 days and 40 nights. He remained to prove all people that will one day come up and say that Jesus didn't die. Jesus didn't resurrect. Wrong. The Bible testifies his death, his resurrection, and after his resurrection, how he appeared to the disciples in many occasions and appeared to many people, many places, and performed wonders among the disciples to prove that he was, he is, and he is to come. Another mystery is the mystery of the queen of the coast, the Babylon, the woman of Babylon, the woman that has caused the whole earth to cause idolatry and fornication. That is his area, her area. Her area of domain, idolatry and fornication. Idolatry. You adorn things that are not of God. And you will celebrate things that will lead you away from God. And you sleep and enjoy things that will make you vulnerable in the sight of God. This woman has wonders, has mystery. Her judgment is at stake. Verse 9. And here is the mind which had wisdom. The seven hairs are seven mountains on which the woman sits. Seven mountains. Tomorrow we talk about that. Seven hairs are seven mountains. What we're talking about mountains, we are talking about high places. Places of honor, places of glory, places of authority, places where she reveals his power. I've mentioned some of them today. Today, terms might not be geographical location, but it can be belief system. It can be culture. It can be ideas, suggestions, and thoughts that we have accepted into our everyday life, thinking that will promote us. It is the mainstreams of our life. Mainstreams of our life. Politics. Excuse me. Politics, religion, medicine, secular medication, medicine. Religion, culture, money, entertainment, all these areas that woman rules over there. And these, there are seven kings. Five are fallen, one of is and the other is not yet to come. And when he come, he must continue a short peace. It is my prayer that you will not give yourself to all these things. Are there going to be many inventions? There are some that are yet to come. The time that Brother John was seeing all this revelation, there are so many things that have come. Today, we have techniques. Technique. I believe that is the one which has come now, that Satan is using mightily. The system, technology is one of the last days weapon that Satan is using. He used the money, he used politics, he used culture, he used tradition, he uses religion. I've mentioned religion, using history in the past, using our literature, and now what he's using is technology that has gone to very high, and all technology are coming from Satan. And bringing, sometimes when we explain Bible, we take it high and this part and bad about about. I have understanding where people, but this is how I see things from God's point of view. Technology. Here he's talking about the technology. Things that are falling and are going to fall now. Technology will fail. It can fail. I don't know what is happening in the UK, but I think this week I've seen some things in technology falling out and falling down and falling down. Sometimes your mobile phone will cut off. Last night we were at work and the nerve center, they have NHS has a system where all the patients, their names have recorded on it. So you take their just mobile, something like mobile phone is a part, and all the information are there. Just last night, information just broke off. You couldn't access anything. You can fail. Sometimes computer fails. I don't know what is happening, but I see something. There are some changes going on. Give your heart to Christ, for all other grounds are sinking sand. Conclusion. Verse 8. There are 7 kings. 5 are fallen. 1 is, and the other is not yet to come. And when it comes, he must continue a short peace. Technology has been the last one. I believe technology is going to be the last principles and power that Satan is going to use. Technology is going to be the last. That is why you can hear me wherever you are listening to me from Nigeria, from Ghana, from America, from Asia, from entire Europe. You can listen to me now. That's technology, the power of technology. What can we use? We born again believers. We can use the same technology that Satan is using to destroy people. Now, if you want to fornicate, you don't need to go far. You can masturbate with a lady on phone. You can do telephone one. You can do live. They send me requests every now and then if I want to do with them. Satan will invite me, Gabriel. They send me from Facebook, social media, from Skype. Can you put on your video on and let us have fun? I said, do you want to go to hell? That is where you want to go and you want to take me there? The devil is a liar. As much as you try to convince them and bring them to Christ, they have one, they've been sent to destroy you. So straight away you block them. Don't take any friend request from any person that you don't know. Basically, any other person has not dressed, if a woman has not dressed modestly, covering her head, putting on, removing worldliness out of her life, don't accept her as friends. So on Facebook, I do not accept people who are not walking on the direction where I'm going again. Some men are behind all these things, you know. They are using scam. They bring a man picture. And most of you women who are very, 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 very miserable are women who are looking for boyfriend and husband on Facebook. People will come over, have a scam. There is a mushroom, a special mushroom that comes out of a palm tree when it is dead. It's got some kind of nice, juicy mushroom. You can get it only on a dead tree. The one that just soaked, that you can get that mushroom from them or from a palm tree when it is dead and decayed. Some of you want to get that mushroom on Facebook. Something juicy. The devil is a liar. Some of you want to get success in the pastor's hands. There's nothing like that. I wouldn't go to work if there is success. There is natural success apart from dedicating your heart to God and receiving the success of God that give you the fullness of the satisfaction that you lack nothing, you need nothing, you have no want of anything. That is a blessing that Christianity has, not physical money blessing. Yes, money blessing are part of it. You lack nothing. You don't depend upon any person. But sometimes you might depend upon people, one way or the other. But that doesn't mean that God is against you. Give your heart to Christ. And turn your heart away from social media, which Satan is using as a tool to destroy people. There are many preachers today also. Many pastors are fake. Many. 99.9% pastors on television. 99.9% on radio. 99.9% on Facebook. You are not preaching the holiness, righteousness, and truth. Endorsing and rebuking sin. They are not promoting you to heaven. Run away from them when you see them wearing rings, wearing them chains. Run away from them. Jesus has not called them. He hasn't called them and he won't call such. The one that God calls, God dresses them, put on the beauty of glory upon them. Not the worldliness and other things that are necessary. It is my prayer. That's as you're listening to these messages, this message will change you and you will give your heart totally and fully to Jesus Christ and he will become your personal savior. All that I preach or teach about is intimacy with Jesus Christ. You will know the truth and the truth shall set you free. If Jesus become your personal savior, all other errors will find their way out in your life. And it is my prayer that the understanding concerning the things of the spirit will be enlightened. And that you begin to see God from different parts. You begin to see God from different level. Your level of understanding will be matured. Your level of communication will go higher. And your way of presenting the word of God will be presenting the word of God in such a way that it will draw people closer to God. God bless you, Sister Margaret. God bless you, brothers and sisters. I know many of you are watching me today. And I do take it as a great opportunity for you, not for me. I take no delight in many people that listen to me. I have no delight, I have no interest. But my interest is those who listen to this message and allow those messages to change them. That is where my delight is. If you are listening to me and you've not given your life to Jesus Christ, you go to church every day. You might be a preacher. You might be prophetess, but you know deep within you that if Jesus comes today, you can't make it. There is no differences between you, Sister Heather or Brother Heather. Robert, God bless you, brother. God bless you for watching. And I pray that your understanding concerning these things will be very, very clear. You go to church, but you dress like a whore. Today, we're talking about the prostitute, the woman prostitute in the church, in the society. We are misleading our women to put on all the outward adornments that makes them beautiful. I don't know, but from infancy, I have seen that when a woman cover her nakedness and cover herself, she looks so beautiful to me. To be honest with you, when I see Islam, Muslim women, I just admire them. I don't lust after them. I just admire them. I just admire them. Covering their face, covering every part of them. I just admire them. And that's how women are supposed to be, you know. I know that you disagree with me. You totally disagree with me because you don't have the heart of Christ. When your heart changes, you begin to see things in that manner. Sister, exposing your nakedness is from the devil. Pastor, exposing your nakedness and endorsing that is from the devil. Teach people to come out of that place and their soul will be saved. Desire and required things that will cause men and women that their name will be written in the Lamb's book of life. The last verse that we read in Revelation 17 verse 10, he said, and these people's names were not found in the book from the beginning of creation. Is your name in? You go to church, ask yourself, is my name in the Lamb's book of life? What makes my name to be written in? Accepting Jesus as my personal savior and living every second of my life for him, not of myself. Living every day to see that his will is what I'm pursuing. His desire is my desire. Thing that he died for is what I am ready to die for. If that is your quest, let us pray together. Maybe you haven't done that. Why don't you do it today? Call upon his name. Ask him to forgive you all your sin. People that you have cheated, people that you have lied to, people that you have duped, people that go back, we call it restitution. Restore back peace with people. Whatsoever you have taken from people, go and give them back. Whatsoever you have taken from the country, the nation, go and give them back to people that belongs to them. And have peace with God. Salvation is incomplete without restitution. Salvation is incomplete without restitution. Salvation is incomplete without the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Salvation is incomplete without personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Let's seek this relationship and our life will be pure. In Jesus' name. Father, thank you for this opportunity given to your children that we will listen to the truths that we may be set free. Here we are, O God. Come to agreement with them as they're going to confess their sin and tell you to come into their life and change them for heaven, for heavenly race, that they will live every second, every minute of their life for you. We thank you that you are welcoming us. Sister, brother, if you're listening to me and you want to dedicate your heart to Christ, pray this prayer with me. Say, Jesus, I believe you're the Son of God. I believe you died for my sins. I am a sinner. Forgive me, Lord. Cleanse me from unrighteousness. Deliver my soul from the hands of the enemy. And set my heart pure. Please give me your mind. Please give me your Holy Spirit. Please give me your heart. Let me live my life for you. All the days of my life. In Jesus' name. If you want to make heaven, you need the heart of Christ, the mind of Christ, and the spirit of Christ. I'll help you to live your everyday life by studying the word of God, prayer and fasting, abstaining from anything which is unclean, and live your life every day to please God. That you can't move without God. You can't move without Jesus Christ holding your hands. If that is the type of relationship that you're looking for, I encourage you to continue to listen to my teachings 24/7. This day, I don't have any pastor, to be honest to you, to introduce him to you. All that I can say is that love your Bible above everything. I've been endorsing so many pastors, but none of them endorse me. Most of them, at the end of the day, I've become disappointed. So I decided not to promote any pastor any longer whatsoever. But I introduce Jesus to you because that is whom and the reason why I'm here. I entreat you to have a personal relationship with Jesus. Find a church in your area which you think it can help you. Pray and seek God's face, and God will grant you a minister, a pastor. Until you find one, why don't you make Brother Gabriel your friend? I will study the word of God with you. I will coach you the ways of God. I'm very sensitive towards God. And I pray that you have the same hearts. Above anything that I want you to have is the heart of Christ. The heart of Christ. The heart of Christ that hates sin, love righteousness, and therefore that will bring the upliftment. May you receive the heart. Let's pray for that. Say, Jesus, give me your hearts. Lord, give me your hearts. Lord, give me the hearts of yours in the name of Jesus. Go, son, that our Father, baptize your people with your hearts. You give it to me and I change everything of me. The heart like yours is what they need. In Jesus' name. You can listen to Brother Gabriel 24/7 on Facebook. My name is Gabriel Adade, Pastor Gabriel Adade, or Love Adade. Love is my wife. So I post some of my messages over there, some of my videos. I share it over there. Go to YouTube, the same name, Pastor Gabriel Adade or Love Adade. That on this name, you will find many videos that by the grace of God, the Lord has granted me to teach about. Besides that, you have my personal online radio, Christian online radio, 24/7. It is being broadcast on TuneIn. It's End Time Radio UK. End Time Radio UK or End Time Holiness Radio. Whenever you see that radio, please click 24/7. You hear my voice teaching the word of God. Oh my God. Some of the things that the Holy Spirit have taught through me, it amazes me. You will rejoice. You will enjoy that. On podcast, the same name, Pastor Gabriel Adade. Go and listen to these teachings and it will help you. It's for free. I don't sell any material. I don't take money. I don't take collection. I don't take tithes. I take nothing. I just want to win your soul to Christ. Your soul is all that I want to take for Christ. If you can borrow me that, give me 5 minutes of your attention every day and let me give it to Christ, and I bet you you'll be rewarded in heaven now and forevermore. Until we meet again, Father, I pray and I come into divine agreement with brothers and sisters whom you have drawn closer to me, oh God. They don't come because of me, but they come because of you. They are searching for you. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, let not the expectation be cut off. Let every person who is being challenged, Father, to follow this ministry. I pray that, Lord, you grant them a clean heart and a pure heart. A clean heart and a contrite spirit. that they will live every day for you. I rebuke every sin. I rebuke every weaknesses. Father, their pains is my pains. Their joy is my joy. Whatsoever they are going through, I come together into agreement with them, with God, and I plead that let the blood of Jesus set their soul free. Lord, set their soul free. In Jesus' name. If you have a problem that you want us to pray about, I'll be very, very pleased. Contact me on Facebook, contact me on email, contact me, and we will agree and pray together. May God richly bless you for all of you who made this day very beautiful. Until we meet tomorrow, God's will, and at the same time, please tune in and follow the next teachings on Revelation chapter 17. I believe we're going to pick it from verse 12 downwards. Tomorrow, God's willing, we shall meet. I love you all. And God bless you. I do appreciate that God has brought you together to be part of what God is doing through my life. God bless you. You define my purpose. You define my reason of here. God bless you. I love you. Bye-bye.